Hey, what's up, everybody? Happy Wednesday to you. Just coming at you, this is not, of course, Music Monday. I didn't do a video this past Monday, but in case you missed it, make sure to check out the Music Monday post, which was Emily Sandee's version of events. It was a CD review I did of her CD, Our Version of Events, so make sure you check that out if you haven't already. And following this Monday coming up, I'll definitely be back on regular schedule, but just did not get a chance to film a video this past Monday. But for today, there is a first for Peauxetic Expressions. This is the first Wednesday video that I've ever done. I'm doing three different stories today for What the Hell Wednesday. In case y'all don't know what that is, I'm basically reporting on news events or things that I see or hear about or feel that will make you say, what the hell. So there's three different stories that I'm covering today, and the name of the blog is What the Hell in 3D. And make sure to check it out today at www.poeticexpressions.com. And the first story that's up is about a mayor of Talkeetna, Alaska, which is a historical district, so their political workings aren't as the same as it would be in, let's say, maybe a more developed city or a larger city. So anyway, they've had an honorary mayor there for the past 15 years, and this mayor is a cat. Yeah, Mayor Stubbs is a cat. And not only is he a cat, he's a cat that drinks out of wine glasses, and he's attracting all of these tourists, and everybody's saying, oh yeah, he's so great, and you know, we love him, and he's so easy to work with. I'm like, yeah, of course, it's a cat, so what do you expect? So anyway, all I gotta say is I would love to be Mayor Stubbs' manager. But another story that I have, I'm talking about today, is from Tori Hansen. You may have heard about her. Her case has actually been kind of ongoing for a while, and it's kind of come to a head this week recently. But basically what happened with her is she adopted a Russian boy, 7 years old, and after a series of behavioral problems, she just decided she could not put up with it anymore and sent him on a plane by himself back to Moscow. And it just sounds a little cruel to say that you're sending a 7-year-old kid back on a plane by themselves, but if you heard what this child has done, it can maybe make you see a little bit as to why she did what she did. I mean, he spat on her. Y'all know how I feel about spitting. I think that is just the ugliest, most disrespectful thing that you can do to somebody. I think that I actually would rather be hit than spit on. It's just so disrespectful to me. But anyway, he spat on her, he hit her, he threatened her as well as her mom, threatened to kill them, and also threatened to burn the house down. So that is like some real life children of the corn type stuff. So anyway, she sent him back, and there were a lot of court appearances that she missed since she sent him back. This has been over the span of 2 years. And basically it came to a head, and the judge upheld that she's going to have to pay $150,000 in child support. So imagine that. You're paying child support. You know, it's one thing to pay child support for a child that you get to see every other weekend, or maybe you don't see because, you know, you just choose not to be part of that child's life for whatever reason, which is also sad. But just imagine paying child support on a kid that is not only in the same state, or not in the same state, but they're out of the country, you know. So that's what she's going to have to pay, and part of it is due to her missed court appearances. So that's definitely, you know, really a touchy situation there. And the last thing I'm reporting on is Steven Stein. He is a dentist out of Colorado who has exposed over 8,000 people over the course of 10 years to HIV, hepatitis B and C. You may be wondering, okay, well, how did he do this? He was using unclean needles and syringes. And, you know, my thing is, you know, that's definitely a what the hell, because who does that? You know, who uses unclean needles and syringes in the medical field? And, you know, not like you've done it once or twice, but this has been going on for a span of over 10 years. So needless to say, all of his patients are now getting checked. Thankfully, no one has HIV or hepatitis B or C. Any cases like that haven't come up yet, but and hopefully they won't. But that's just, again, really crazy. You know, I don't see how that something like that went unnoticed for so many years and why this is just now coming out. So, you know, sad thing that he lost his, you know, license to practice, but at the same time, can't use unclean needles. I mean, come on now. So make sure you check out today's post, and I'm interested to see what y'all think about it, about these scenarios and what you would do in these situations, and you know, just what you think in general about it. So make sure to leave your comments at www.poeticexpressions.com. And again, it's called What the Hell in 3D. So make sure you check it out. If you missed it, again, Emily Sandee's version of events. That was my Monday post for Music Monday. And I have some really interesting blogs coming up for you. Make sure you check out Friday's blog coming up. I won't reveal what it's about, but I will reveal the title of it. It's going to be called It's Not All About You. And I also have an interesting music review coming up for this Monday that I'm sure a lot of you all will be excited about. And just make sure you check out the website. Again, it's www.poeticexpressions.com. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel and keep watching the videos. Let me know what you think. Feel free to leave your comments, you know, whether good, bad. You know, hey, I like to hear the raw and honest truth of what you think. So everybody have a great Hump Day Wednesday, and hope you enjoy the vlog.
When you need to smile, but you can't afford it, go on, point it out, I'm gonna steal it. When the floor is more familiar than the ceiling, I will break in late at night, shake up how you're feeling. I'll never stop breaking the law for you. I'll never stop helping to pull you through. Whatever it takes to get what you need, ignore the alarms, ignore the police.